to all of you. Today we are going to start the topic how to calculate the time. I already sent to you the material which is necessary for all of you to read and understand, but here I am going to explain to you how to calculate the time. But before understand the calculation of time, you must have to learn about the revolution of the earth. So look at here. This is the diagram of the revolution of the earth. There are four faces of the earth. Out of these four, these two faces are very, very important. This face is called winter solstice in the month of the December 21 or 22, and this face is called the summer solstice in the month of the 21st or the 22nd June. And these two faces called the equinox. It means 12 hour day, 12 hour night. Why it is very important to understand? Because most of the time when somebody have asked you why season is changing, students give the simple answer, because of the revolution. No doubt it is partially true, but it not absolutely true. We are observing the different types of season because of the revolution of the earth and the tilt of the earth, that is 23.5 degrees. This is very, very important. If this tilt is not being there, then it means we have not experiencing any season. Look at here this diagram. From 0 degree to north is called northern hemisphere, and from 0 degree to south is called southern hemisphere. If one start moving from 0 degree to north in the winter solstice, we observing shorter day. And if you start moving from 0 degree equator to the south, the day will become longer and longer, because this southern hemisphere is toward the sun, and while the northern hemisphere is away from the sun. That's why the duration of the day becomes shorter and shorter. When this earth revolves and reach to this point, when the northern hemisphere is toward the sun and the southern hemisphere is away from the sun, so the northern hemisphere start receiving the sunlight while southern hemisphere is away from the sun. That's why over the southern hemisphere there is a winter, and over the north there is a summer. It means if you start moving from equator toward the north, the day become longer and longer, and in the southern hemisphere the day becomes shorter and shorter. If you reach to this point, the northern pole, the day should be of 24 hours. That's why most of the time we call 6 month day and 6 month night. It is very important for all of you to understand why day become longer and day become shorter. So this is a short video to understand about the revolution